What is up, no coders? If you are ready to put your Airtable data in a timeline view, you don't want to miss this video. We're going to be going into detail about how to implement the new view that was just released from Airtable for timeline. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth Pronovost. I am the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we help you to organize and automate your business. So if that's of interest and you want to learn more about how we do that, do check out the links below this video and don't miss my free Airtable automation webinar. Once a week, I hop on a live webinar and I teach you the fundamental building blocks of automation. Personally, I save 20 hours per week, and I do the same for many of my clients. So if that's of interest and you want to learn how to get started building automation so that you can reclaim all of that time, check out the link below. Or just sign up at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. And even if you can't make the live version, I will be sure to get a replay in your inbox. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this video. We are talking about the new timeline view that came out from Airtable. Let's hop right into it and take a look at my screen so that we can see what an example of this looks like. So very similar to the Gantt view, you're gonna see that you have a start and an end date and or date time for your different records here. They're also able to be grouped by one or more grouping fields. So let's first take a look at the date settings that we have here. And we can see that, again, you're gonna have a start and an end for whatever that duration is that you're tracking per record. And then you can also decide if you wanna have all calendar days or only Monday through Friday. As soon as you make that Monday through Friday selection, you also get the option of adding some holidays. So if you have certain holidays that you don't wanna have showing up on your charts for whatever reason or on your views, you can definitely include them here. All right. Now, beyond that, we can look at our labels. This is another really cool feature for this view. We can actually bring in whatever we want into this particular label on this view. And this is a very unique thing because this is not something we can do for all of our other records in our other views in Airtable, right? This particular one allows us to, in this case, include the status and two date fields here. Now let's rewind a little bit and look at our grid view so we can just look at the raw data that we've got living here. I have a name field, I have a status field, and I have two dates. Let's make this a little bit more robust. We're gonna include time fields here, and similarly on my date two, I'll include a time field, and I'll just change a few of these so that we've got a few different pieces of information floating around. All right, now let's give these some names. And now our records are looking a little bit more put together. Flipping back into that timeline view, now we can see that we're actually getting the actual name from that name field, and then where applicable, if the record is long enough, or if the duration between the two date times is long enough, then we're also seeing the entire name here. So that is a really cool feature that we can actually customize these labels. If we want to bring in the status, for example, we can just by one click bring that right in, and we can even change the way it appears, adding bold or italicized, and that's a really cool feature. I hope that Airtable takes this one element and brings it into so many other views that it has, because being able to visualize our records not only by name, but by including all these other fields, and then even being able to dress it up a little bit by enriching the formatting of that text, that's really cool. Now let's set one of these views up for ourselves from the beginning. And I think you'll find that Airtable's done an exceptional job at walking us through the steps we need to take when setting up our view. Let's get into it and I'll show you what I'm talking about. So to start, we're just gonna add a new timeline view by clicking on the bottom left corner of the screen. Name it whatever you'd like. I'll stick with the name Timeline 2. And the first prompt here says choose your date fields. I only have two date fields, so I'm gonna include them already. They're already selected for me, and I'll click Next. The next part that it asks is, you know, how do you want to group these records? And this is something that's somewhat unique to the timeline view itself. How do we want to group them? How do we want to organize these different timeline pieces on our view? So in our case, we only have that status field that really makes sense to group by, so I'll do that for now, but we'll come back and change that in a moment. Now, you can add additional groupings if you'd like. We're going to skip that for now. And I'm going to click Next. And again, here's where we're choosing the custom label that we want. I'll stick with, let's say, the name field, and then I'll only bring in that first date, and I'll embolden the name text, and then we'll click Done. So that's very similar to the way it was showing up in our previous one. You can also then, once it's created, come up into the upper right corner and decide how much you want to see on your screen at one time. It defaults to week, but maybe I want to see the whole month, for example, and I can just now see the whole month and scroll that back and forth between them. Now, how can we use that grouping field in a way that is more advanced? Well, maybe these are tasks that are needing to be performed or projects that our team is working on, and one of those resources that we need to see is our team members, like who's available, when are they available, etc. So let's drop in and go back to our grid view and actually add a collaborator field here. Now, normally what I would do here is use a collaborator field type, but because this will allow us to only name collaborators that have the base shared with them, it's kind of a moot point for me to do that because this base is only shared with me. So instead, let's make it a single select field. And now I can create several different fake collaborators. And so I'll have person one, person two, and person three. And I'll save this up and I'll add a few collaborators here to the different projects. Maybe I'll just use person one and person two for now. Now we can flip back into timeline two here and go to our groupings, and here we can actually add another grouping, right? We'll add collaborator, and we will reorganize these so that the collaborator grouping takes precedent over the status grouping. So let's really quickly collapse our status grouping now, and we can see that the first grouping is done by person. And so person one and person two, and actually, let's rearrange some of these records so that person two doesn't have all the done records. Let's make person one have some done records as well. Flipping back into timeline, this is going to make a lot more sense. So underneath person one, we see all three statuses grouped under person one. And then similarly, all of the statuses that apply for person two are grouped under person two. So clearly, this is a great view for you to use if you're trying to track the application of resources, like people, for example, inside of your team. If you want to make sure that people are booked or that they have availability or however you want to track that, the timeline view is one you're probably going to want to consider for a lot of your use cases. One last piece to look at here is the coloring of these records. By default, they have been assigned the same color as the status, but of course, as is true with any other view in Airtable, we can adjust this coloring to our liking. So we can remove this rule if we'd like, and we can set up some conditions. We might say the name, if the name contains the word name, then it's going to be red or whatever this color is. So if we were to go back into our grid view, we see, of course, that all of our names are including the word name, but let's change one. So now I've changed this for person one, flipping back into the timeline there. We should see those load up in just a moment. And if we open that up, we see that this no longer has that color. So just as it's true in all of your other Airtable views, you can apply some color rules if you're on the pro plan to the different views so that you can see your records and they show up in a way that helps you make sense of them quickly and efficiently. Now I need to point out that this timeline view does require that you're on a pro plan. If you are not on the pro paid plan of Airtable or better, then you will not have access to this. So this is another reason that you will very likely want to consider signing up for that pro plan, especially if you're using Airtable to its fullest extent. Now lastly, we also need to discuss the other features that are available to other views, specifically the way that we share those views and also the row height. So just as you can with other views, you can change the record height. Something that's a little unique to the timeline view, though, is that you can change the orientation of the label. Let's look at what I mean here. By clicking on this section here, you can adjust the height of the records. Let's make them tall. So obviously we get a much longer, a much taller record there that's being displayed for each of them. But the label orientation is a new thing that we have not had control over in the past. If we flip it to vertical, what you'll find is that all of the different elements that you've included inside of the label for your record, they are stacked on top of each other. So for my example here, I have the name, and then next to that, I have start date one. So let's include, flipping out of here, let's go back to our customized labels, and I'm going to bring in the date two. And now you see that all three of those elements are stacked on top of one another inside of my label. Now, if I make a change to this, of course, if I go back to that and I make it horizontal, again, now it's going to be trying to put everything in one line. And where it can't, then, of course, it has a line break and starts the next line. So that's a really cool feature as well. This is specific to this view, at least at present, because this is the only view that allows us to get that level of flexibility in our label. I hope you got a ton of value out of this and that you start using that timeline view to its fullest extent. If you have any questions, please drop them below in the comments, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.